What in the foolery was this season? A lot of red flags from Clay that were visible to the blind and audible to the deaf. I don't think there's anything you're gonna do to make him ready. So to me, she seems like the type of friend that would tell her friend, oh, that he's messing up, but end up dating a douchebag. Oh, now for Clay. We forgot to press record. Kenneth, please, can you say that again? I don't understand the kind of people that you brought for this season. The chemistry between both of them was just too much for friendship. It's heading for the rocks. Me, if I'm him, I would not have come. For a man to admit that he's toxic, Oburu, when your chest is filled with lies, that's how you'll be sitting. How many of you will be comfortable with your man being 5 meters close to someone he slept with? Hey guys, hey beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Yechi here, and today's video, I'm quite excited about it, weirdly. Never done something like this before, but we're going to be talking about Love is Blind. Everything I picked up from this season, my opinion on the couples, you know, the ones that made it to the altar and the ones that did not. I actually watch a lot of reality TV show and I enjoy it so much. Like I enjoy having discussions like about it with people, because I feel like sometimes my point of view is always like everybody's coming from this side, yet you will not come from this side. And I just want to talk about it. I would say this season was like my least favorite season. Actually, was I invested in the drama? I was invested in it. And see, with Love is Blind, yeah, there are two different ways to watch it. Watch it on Netflix and that's that. Then when you watch it with TikTok and Twitter, you get the full experience. Like, I feel like if you watch it on Netflix alone and then you just go to bed, like, that's not complete. You're not done. It's just like eating, licking the ice cream and not taking the cone. You didn't have the whole thing. But when you add TikTok and Twitter to it, nah, you really watch this season. And that's exactly how I watched this season. I was so invested in it. I feel like it's a very weird experiment, but it turns out to be very interesting. Yeah, and I feel like for the first time, yeah, I want to talk about this on my channel so we can gist about it, you know, in the comment section. Let me know what you guys think about this season. I think I mentioned it in my Cambridge vlog that I'm not feeling any of the couples. And I honestly did not. Maybe the only couple that actually made it to the altar. Like I said, it was so obvious that the success rate of this season was going to be so low. Kudos to Amy and Journey for actually like making it to the altar, you know, still being married like a year later, because like they brought out the reunion. And most of the things I'm going to be talking about is like from the reunion, because when I was done with that reunion, I'm like, what in the foolery was this season? What exactly did we just witness on national television? So much to talk about, honestly. But yeah, let's get into it. I think I'm going to like maybe pick it like couple by couple, or yeah, just ramble, mumble, jumble, anyhow. I just, yeah, get into it. So first things first, let's get into like, I think the couple that gave us like the most drama this season, and that's AD and Clay. Did I see that they would not make it past the altar? Definitely. Like, I think it was actually quite clear. We're just all just waiting for the point where it's going to happen. And I really hoped and prayed that AD would be the one to not go through. Like, she would be the one to say, I do not. I was really hoping that she would be the one, because there were a lot of red flags from Clay that were visible to the blind and audible to the deaf. There were just a lot of things, like, you know, him just always bringing up like his dad. And I mean, this is someone that is not even sure of himself and seeing like himself as a husband. She kind of felt like, oh, okay, you know, if I do more for him, if I try my best for him, you know, I would be enough for him. So that's why when he called it off, and then she was saying things like, oh, she feels like, you know, she's not enough. Like, she just keeps on doing.
And I keep like doing so much for these men and carrying these fucking relationships, and like, it's just not fucking enough. And I don't know what else to do, really.
I honestly need her and like women globally for, you know, us to make a pledge that you can't exactly do something to, like, marriage is a very serious decision, and if someone is not ready, okay, you can, yeah, like date them, you guys can get to know each other and see where it's going, but there's nothing that you really, especially for men, yeah, I don't think there's anything you're gonna do to make him ready. When he's ready, if you are around him, then you, there was so, I saw a tweet one day that said that men literally just live their lives and they are just, you know, going through different stages of life. And then when they decide, oh, they want to get married, they're just like, left, right, left, right. Who is around me? Grab you. And yes, I do. And yeah, that's an extreme. Honestly, it's an extreme. So it's not always the case. But I just feel like we need to stop having that mindset. So if you yourself, you're ready to settle down, be with someone who is ready to settle down. Don't be with someone you like and then, well, make them ready to settle down. It doesn't work that way. And I really wish more people would like pick from what happened in their situation and bring it home. Like, there's really nothing you can do. If someone is not ready, then the person is not ready. If you can wait, wait. If you can't wait, move along, okay? It might be quite, you know, difficult to hear, but you don't want to just become like very sad in the relationship because you're not getting what you want. So I don't like that she had that mindset. She's such a babe. She's such a sweet and like nice person, to be honest, because, you know, her saying that, oh, she's always giving, giving, giving. She seems like the one person to like really make sacrifices in relationships. And I feel like, you know, she just needs to understand that, okay, I need to find someone who's on that same wavelength with me and then we move together. Not that you find someone who's trying to piece his puzzles together while yours is already put together. Another thing I really like about AD is that she's a no-nonsense person. So we saw the way she spoke up to Sarah and...
Mm-hmm. That you said to him.
Yeah.
You don't think it's a little outlandish to tell a man who just got engaged that if the door's still open...
So the way she also looked at Trevor, which we're going to get into.
Say it with your chest. Don't get quiet now.
You saw the way she looked at Trevor, like, with so much, like, what are you saying? Like, say with your full chest. Like, she literally told him that. She's a no-nonsense person. But I wish she would bring that home. Like, I wish she would really bring it home. Or I wish she would have brought it home with Clay. So, to me, she seems like the type of friend that she's really a girl's girl that would tell her friend, oh, you know, what your man is not doing is right, you're messing up, or rather he's messing up, this, you need to talk to him about this, but end up dating a douchebag. She's very good at removing the speck in other people's eyes with her own. See inside her eyes, very mighty and big there. It just seemed like to me she's not tolerating like a lot of like off energies like throughout the season, yeah, but she literally took a lot. And that whole part of her saying that she went back to Matthew, like she went on a few dates with him, I'm just like, what were you looking for? Why? Like, what was the reason? In my opinion, it was not necessary. If you wanted to apologize, apologize like over the phone. Like, girl, you are such a babe. Like, such a babe and deserve absolutely what more that you're going for. And with her and Clay, I feel like she hasn't shut the door and she's just hoping that, you know, him working on himself, you know, going therapy, I feel like she's still lingering around because she really likes the idea of them being together and she just wants to maybe linger around to see, oh, is he gonna be ready? Because I don't think she has really shut that door, okay? We've seen like interviews, you know, of her saying that they're still like buddies and all. And when she was like, when they asked the question, oh, would you date him again? And she was like, next question. Oh, can you publicly, with your full chest, the same way you told Trevor with your chest, can she with her chest explain her situation like with Clay and like what is going on? I just feel like she needs to shut that door and move on to better things. Just focus on herself and finding someone, you know, that is ready at the same time. Now for Clay. You see, one thing I like is when people can see through bullshit. That's one thing I love the most. And the internet yesterday was not having like it with like everything Clay said. It was, to me, was akuko. That story. All that thing of I'm working on myself, you know, therapy, this and all. I honestly find it very annoying that you come on a show like that and you're not even ready for marriage. And he said something that was very triggering. I would say gaslighting as well. You know, telling AD, why does the timeline matter? This is not, oh, we met at the bar and we're just getting to know each other. It's Love is Blind. The experiment is meant to end in marriage. That's the plan. That's what we came here for. And you got engaged to me. You met my family. I met your family. we're planning a wedding, you picked a suit. Like, we did all of this, you weren't sure. And then you're like, I don't understand. Like, the timeline is part of what you signed up for. You were aware of it. And it's not just you on that rollercoaster of emotions. There's someone else with you. And I honestly feel like this season, a lot of feelings were disrespected. A lot of feelings were disrespected. And it's just not cool. Because even if you didn't come here for something serious, someone else did. And that's something you should consider. So it's either you tell them early enough, or you just don't come at all if you're not a serious person, honestly. So with Clay, I honestly feel like, yeah, it's good that, you know, he's going, you know, to therapy, and definitely you can see that there's a way upbringing affects like your choice when it comes to like marriage. I just would really like for him to focus on his therapy, like just focus on it and give AD the room to let her breathe, possibly like see other people. I don't know, I don't like when we're no longer a thing and then you're still trying to box me. Like, you still want us to be like as close as ever before. You know, you still want me to be your, like, when anything happens to me, you still want me to call you, but we are not in like a committed relationship. I feel like it's just very, it's like trying to eat your cake and have it. It's either you are in or you're out. If you're out, be out, be out. Don't be on the corridor. Be out. And if you're in, let's know what we're doing. And I just feel like both of them have not really come to terms like with what's going on, and somebody's going to get hurt very soon. Somebody. And I think we both know who that person is. It's not clear. All right, so let me get into Kenneth and Brittany, the principal. And the kid, that girl is so beautiful. Like, she's so pretty. And she looks even more beautiful at the reunion. Their whole breakup situation was very, very messy. I personally feel like it was reacted. Like, it had already happened. And then they're like, oh, we forgot to press record. Kenneth, please, can you say that again? I literally want to believe that's what happened. So that's why the story was not exactly complete. I also wish they gave them more screen time at the reunion. You see this friendship and buddies that they are doing? Wrap it up. Please wrap it up. I don't understand the kind of people that you brought for this season. Like, why do you want to make life complicated for yourself? It's one thing for you to, oh, maybe you dated someone, you guys broke up, and then you're friends. It's another thing for you to be engaged, it ended, and then you're friends. It's another thing for you to, you got engaged, you broke up on national TV, everyone knows. I just feel like it's making it very complicated for them going into future relationships separately. You are constantly, oh, he calls me, you know, we talk from time to time, we're on FaceTime, this. Me, as a girl, let's just assume, I meet Kenneth, and I'm meant to understand that you are very close to your ex, not just dated ex, but engaged ex that the whole world knows. I'm meant to be cool with that. I don't know, if people are going to end things, just end things. Like, why are you trying to, like, there's a lot of eating your cake and having it like going on. If you're going to end, which one is you poor close with you poor guys or something? I didn't understand that, and I just felt like the chemistry between both of them during the reunion was just too much for friendship.
I was reaching at this point, which I think is fantastic.
If
a lasting friendship comes out of this, that's amazing. Do you guys give each other dating advice? Have you gotten to the place where you are comfortable doing that?
Hey, you want to talk about our conversation the other day?
Nah, I've seen friends, like close friends of opposite sex. They don't have chemistry like that. Is that they are not telling us the truth, or they are deceiving themselves? That two things. Is that they're not telling us the truth, or they're deceiving themselves? Because what was going on? The whole, you know, lap touching, how, you know, they're looking at it. I'm like, Kenneth, let's know what exactly is going on here. You put need to come clean, come correct. Okay. I mean, we've seen couples that didn't make it past the altar, but like after they started dating, like they continued like their relationship, even if they didn't get engaged, even though they didn't get married rather. So if that's the case for you guys, there's no shame in that. Tell us, we'll be happy that at least, you know, the experiment did not completely fail for you guys. But that whole friendship mask that you're doing, we can see through it. At least I can see through it. So another couple, Sarah Ann and Jeremy, is giving Jackie and Josh. We all remember like Jackie from, I think it was season 4. Jackie and La was with Marshall and then, you know, left and then went to be with Josh. It's giving that. And I feel like it's just a matter of time. I mean, Chelsea already revealed that there were times that she met Jeremy and they weren't, I mean, he wasn't dating Sarah Ann at the time.
In the subsequent time.
Since the show. Oh, yeah. Okay. Every time I see him, they're broken up.
Yeah. I just feel like it's heading for the rocks. Is sometime, somewhere. Sometime, somewhere, somehow is going to hit that rock. I don't see it as a very, you know, solid relationship. And I wish Laura the best. Like, I wish her, like, completely, like, the best. I'm very happy she got herself out of that situation because Jeremy wasn't, like, so sure about her. And I honestly, like, just respect. Like, it's not hard. Respect the other person's feelings. And I think, like, this is not even just for Love is Blind, but generally in the dating space, respect other people's feelings. Like, if someone is with you, you poor are not... This was not just, hi, I like you, situationship. No, this is a relationship. You poor are engaged, and then you're going to hangouts. You find you stop, you know, run into, like, the ex you dated on the show, and you just casually stayed in her parking lot till morning. I don't get. Like, even if nothing happened, you make it so hard for you to be trusted doing things like that. Like, it's very simple. If you don't want to smell like smoke, step away from the firewood. Simple. If you know that you don't want to do anything promiscuous or anything, you know, you don't want to cheat on your partner, then just don't give them the vibe that something went on. Like, it's just simple. Her sending the DM definitely was not cool. I'm very happy that AD cleared her on that. Like, give these people some space. Like, they just came out into the real world. This is where they really literally need to, like, solidify their bond. I get that, yes, you're like, oh, they are not married or anything. But I think an engaged relationship should be respected enough for you to, you know, let it go. Yeah, if it comes to you and they are no longer together, and you still fancy him, you can go for it. But for you to be the first one to, like, reach out, that was very unclassy of her. So I honestly wish Laura the best. I'm actually quite happy that she wasn't physically there at the reunion, because, like, we all know that she doesn't have the nicest mouth. I feel like she could have taken it a lot easier on Jeremy as well, just because the way she spoke to him. Yeah, she was pissed off, but some words were used that were not the coolest at all. And maybe she could have been, like, just tad bit nicer to him, okay? Just a little bit. Not nicer, I would say, like, calmer, yeah, with him. So I'm also very happy that they addressed, you know, Sarah Ann's video on TikTok talking about this is reality TV show and she came to, like, give entertainment.
This is a reality television. It is meant to entertain you. And I think that's exactly what we're doing. We didn't miss with this one, baby.
It's not fair that you're using someone's genuine feelings. Like, this girl was in love with this guy, and what you're trying to give is content. Like, I know that, yes, being an influencer is, like, a really big thing in 2024, but have some class, okay? Have some class, have some... I don't even know what to use than class, but this is someone's actual, like, feeling. It's, like, a real experience and a real relationship. If you want to, like, maybe build a brand or become, like, a public figure or something, there are a lot of other reality TV shows you can go for. Maybe you don't have Big Brother in your country, I don't know. But there are other things. Too hot to handle. How about that? Nobody really comes there trying to find true love. There are a lot of other shows that they can explore with less sensitivity. Like, the nature of Love is Blind is very sensitive, and you cannot be saying, oh, I'm giving entertainment and another person is, like, getting hurt, like, genuinely. It's not fair. And that even takes me into Trevor. Trevor has to be, like, the biggest clown and joke of this season. Because what was that? The story with his ex leaked, like, 3 weeks before the reunion, okay? He had a lot of time to figure out what exactly he's going to say. Or he could... Me, if I'm him, I kukuma don't have babe. I kukuma don't have relationship from the show. I would not have come. I would not have come. Anything you want to say, say. If you say it's true, it's true. If you say it's a lie, it's a lie. I would have, just like Matthew, I would have politically declined. I'd be, what did they say he declined? I would have declined. Because what did he come here to say? Like, he was like,
I had a whole thing planned to say. I don't know. I don't fucking know.
Trevor, I gotta ask you.
There is an answer for that.
You're saying I love you.
Yes.
To this woman as you're entering the experiment, as you're entering the pot.
Yes.
So to say, oh, I didn't, she wasn't really my girlfriend. You don't say I love you to someone you don't care about on that level.
I mean, I did care about her.
So that's what you're going with. You didn't really love her. You told her you loved her.
No, I
okay.
He couldn't even like say anything, saying that, oh, him and his babe were like toxic and all. I really pray that him and that girl, they never have anything going on. Because which one is on national TV? You're not saying, oh, we're toxic. You left the show. You found someone, oh, you found like maybe true love there with Chelsea. You felt something with her. You left, you came back. You now said, you love me. And then you are saying that we're toxic. I don't understand. And I know that for like a good amount of American people, like the love word is actually like quite big. So when they use like, I love you in a relationship, it's like a big thing because they're like, oh, okay, you really care about this person. So which one is we were not like girlfriend, boyfriend, like it was not defined. Like respect people's feelings. It's like that should be like the biggest thing from this season. Respect people's feelings. It's not hard. Like I felt secondhand embarrassment. Like I don't even know him. We're not related in any way. I was just so embarrassed for him. And when he asked, can he leave? I said, good. But the thing is, you shouldn't have come at all. Like, why bother? You should have just declined. You don't have any sheep from this Love is Blind. So there was literally no need for your, like, your presence was not so needed. I also feel like there were a lot of, you know, chit chats on TikTok and like the cast, like their social media accounts. And I feel like it spoils like the season because we could tell like certain things. Like we could tell that Sarah Ann and Jeremy are actually together from TikTok before the end of the season. Yeah, like, I don't know. They need to sign, I would say, like closer non-disclosure agreements with like the cast because, yeah, there are certain things that should not like spill out, you know, let people still be guessing. But yeah, that whole situation with Trevor, no, like saying that, oh, we're so toxic, you know, she's toxic, I'm toxic.
I told her that, she knew that, like her and I were so fucking toxic.
So toxic that after you got out of the pods, you said, I'm going to marry you?
No, yes. I'm toxic as well. I admit that.
I'm actually so happy for Chelsea because for a man to admit that he's toxic, Oburu is very toxic. He's so toxic. Because the ones that are toxic don't even admit it. And for you to now be self-aware that you are, you are very, very toxic. So finally, I want to discuss Chelsea. Baby girl, like you had it tough this season, okay? But I'm very sure you came out and even seeing like the stuff with Trevor, you're like, oof, I dodged the bullet with that one. Like, wanna thank you, Eleda, because you for enter serious gaun. She got a lot of comments like on Twitter. Like Twitter was on her, you know, a lot of, you know, tags like being insecure, this and that. And to an extent, was she? Yes. But I honestly feel like a lot of people were throwing so much light on how she reacted that they failed to see what she reacted to. Hear me out. So the first case was the whole issue of, you know, Jimmy and AD. Yeah, when he was, you know, commenting on her body. And then she did one thing. See, don't start what you can't finish. Jimmy commented, you know, you could have a question saying that, oh, her body is nice and all. And then you were like, okay, girl, joining your man to hype her. But you could not finish it because he continued. And what happened? You got offended.
That woman is absolutely stacked. AD? I say that in the most respectful.
Babe, you can say whatever you... She's a bookshelf. AD! Hey, how you get a butt like that? Squats and Jesus, girl. That's it.
I saw what you said. He goes, that girl, she's pretty stacked.
I'm just impressed talking to you.
Thank you.
You're the greatest. I am so embarrassed. She just called me fuck out.
So in this life, don't start what you cannot finish. Which one, if you know you're not cool with your men looking at other women, or you know, even making comments, when they do it, don't go, oh, okay, yes, and you know, you'll not be joining your man to be looking at another man's body. You are, get help. Don't do that, please. Okay, don't think it's going to make you one of the guys and you will feel more comfortable around you. Irony, it's a very, very big lie. It doesn't work that way. Secondly, we had the whole issue where, of course, I feel like that one was extreme because they could have had the conversation, I would say, like later and if possibly off camera, because that was, you know, Jimmy's secret with like his friend was like being shared. But let's look at it. Jimmy is still close and hanging out with a friend that he slept with. Now, how many of you would even let your man be 5 meters close? I won't say let, because yeah, it's not as if you'll be controlling him, but how many of you will be comfortable, let me use the word comfortable, with your man being 5 meters close to someone he slept with? How many? Like, I'm sure a lot of people would not. Yes, she had that breakdown, you know, really pouring and did a lot, or said a lot of things, but at the same time, let's not normalize that. It's not normal. Let's not normalize it. It's not normal. Bear in mind that this is someone that has been in a marriage before that didn't work out. So excuse her if her guards are up approaching this one. I feel like she totally hasn't like healed from certain things and, you know, is still a bit insecure. But let's not turn a blind eye to the triggers. Like, he triggered her. Okay. He definitely triggered her. If she was with someone that made her feel a lot, you know, more safe and like really had his whole like eyes for her and showed it perfectly, I feel like we would not have seen that side of her. Maybe not at the early stage. Maybe like they could have seen it could come out like a few times, because I feel like with insecurities, no matter what the person does, there are times that, yeah, it will still come out because it's there and it's not something that you've addressed. Yeah. But let's not turn a blind side to the things that Jimmy did. It was not cool. There are things, you know, the way he was, you know, commenting, you know, on AD's body, you know, and I mean, Chelsea was still there. She was actually still there. It wasn't cool at all. And I think she has like every right to feel that type of way. Could she have communicated it better? Definitely. Okay, but for everyone just lashing out on her, you know, really calling her out, you know, really saying that she's insecure, when I know that a lot of people would do probably worse if they were in that situation. Jimmy also, I feel like he was really upset with like the whole issue with the friend, like it's coming out, and that's why he didn't want to make it like to the altar. I like the fact that he told her and like didn't take her like all the way and then now say, I'm very happy that he did that. It was still painful to like see her like have that whole breakdown, but from Jimmy's side, not everything was done perfectly right. If we're being honest, not everything was done perfectly right. I feel like if they had gone through with it, they could have had like issues, because the reason why you're not going through with me was because, you know, of the issue with your friend. This is someone that you've been with, so how am I meant to feel like I'm priority? Do you understand? Like, it just rubs off wrong to me, honestly. So I think in both cases, they dodged the bullets, because, yeah, Jimmy, I don't think he was going to give her like that 100%. And I feel like even if Jimmy gave like 100% to like Chelsea, she still would have, you know, been a bit like still insecure, still have like her guards up. And yeah, that's not really what an ideal relationship should be like. I feel like this season, a lot of people still needed to work on themselves before coming on the show. Like, they still needed to fix certain things in their life to properly like prepare themselves for settling down. And if the success rate of this show is going to be high, definitely I would recommend them not just casting, like just picking people, you know, that are interested in getting married, but they should go through like therapy before coming on the show. They should be assessed. Okay, it's not just, oh hi, I want to get married. People need to come on there with the right intention as well. This is not the place to get Instagram followers and build a brand. Yeah, that would happen like alongside, but because other people are there for the right reasons, ensure that everybody's there for like the right reason. So I feel like you need to go through like some form of therapy, assess them properly. Another thing I wanted to mention before I go is I feel like AD's mom, I really expected her to throw, like, I was really hoping that she would hit, you know, AD in the direction of, you know, this man is really not, it doesn't look like he's ready. Because I truly believe that she could see that. I was really hoping that she would say that and, you know, give her daughter some form of advice. I feel like if I saw that type of person for like my daughter, I would, you know, pull you aside, you know, have that conversation with you, just let you know and, you know, okay, I'm seeing this, or from what you're telling me, you know, there's a certain level of readiness I'm not seeing from your partner. Have you guys spoken about it? Blah, 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 blah. But she didn't do that. And it felt like, oh, she was very comfortable with Clay. And, you know, just, oh, AD's happy, so I'm happy. Irony, it doesn't work that way. Which one is, you're happy, I'm happy automatically? No, like, you're a parent for a reason, okay? And I just wish she really chipped that in. I feel like it could have helped AD make her decision. I don't like the fact that this season, and I think most of the other seasons, yeah, the men are the ones, like, saying, like, they can see the issue. What's the name of that? I'm trying to remember his name. The Nigerian guy. Like, he had like the red flags and the girl was like willing to like go through with it. But like he was like, okay, no, let's not proceed. Same thing with like Clay. I really wish AD was the one to like say no. Like, oh, I'm not going through with this. You know, I don't think you're ready. And, you know, let's sit it out, you know, take time and let's see, you know, where we'd be in like a few months. Okay. Not just blindly say yes and hope that everything would be fine. I'm very sure she could see like certain things where a bit off. And yeah, I wish Clay the best. But you see that font he pulled up during the reunion, that he was, this guy was not sitting. When your chest is filled with lies, when you are just lying every day, that's how you'll be sitting. Because it was just like this, don't that, This season was a lot, honestly. And yeah, I'm happy it's done. I can't wait for the next one. And then for Perfect Match as well. I watched season one of Perfect Match, so yeah, I'm hoping that season two is like nice. That brings me to the end of my video talking about Love is Blind season 6. Let me know what you agree or disagree with. I feel like a lot of people disagree with what I said about Chelsea, but yeah, that's fine. Yeah, I hope you guys love this one. Let me know if you want more videos like this. Although, like, is it me to talk about these things? I don't know just yet, but we never really know. So give this video a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see you on my next video.